science, and welcome to the rolling hills of Ireland.
Iceland.
And that's on Iceland.
Yes, sorry for that incredibly lame introduction. My name is Marc West, and this is another edition of the Mr. Science Show, coming to you from Iceland. Now, I'd heard Iceland was a rather beautiful place, but when you get off the plane in Keflavik and you catch the bus, the 1 hour or so journey into Reykjavik, the capital, it's immediately obvious that the area around you is very stark, it's very moonlike. Now, something along the lines of 64% of Iceland's landmass is actually wasteland. It's cooled lava flows. And as you can see here, there's not a lot out there, only a little bit of grass. Now, you can imagine in the middle of winter that this would be a rather beautiful place. Now, one of the beautiful things about Iceland is the Blue Lagoon. The Blue Lagoon is a thermal bath. It gets its blue colour from the silica in the water. And oddly enough, it's actually an offshoot of the power plant next door. Iceland's energy portfolio has 76% renewable energy, and one of the ways it gets its renewable energy is through geothermal sources. And so you can see here that the water is actually an offshoot from the power plant, and the silica is a byproduct. However, silica is in a lot of facial products and such things, and is apparently very good for your skin. And so a lot of people go here to bathe, a lot of the beautiful Icelandic people come here to bathe. Now, this is the Kirio volcanic crater. It formed in an eruption of a volcano about 3,000 years ago and is now 60 odd meters deep and full of water. Full of freezing cold water, mind you. It freezes over in winter. And as you can see here, the landscape of Iceland is very stark. There's not much there. It's very flat, probably because a glacier had moved over it at some stage. And in the corner of this, we are now going to see the Gullfoss waterfall. The Gullfoss waterfall is absolutely spectacular and comes out of this amazingly flat landscape. It just appears out of nowhere. And it's absolutely beautiful. You may all remember how erosion works in your high school geography or geology or whatever it was. I didn't do very much of it. But what's happened is the water has flown through here, meandered through here, and there are various layers in the earth, especially in Iceland, which is formed mainly by volcanic eruptions. And so, as the water goes along, it hits smoother and softer areas of land, and it obviously hit a very soft area and completely eroded it. A lot of this comes up because of Iceland's condition straddling the mid-Atlantic ridge. It's actually growing about a centimeter or so every year because it is straddling the Eurasian and American plates, which are moving apart. And it causes amazing formations like this. And one of the other things it forms are thermal baths, as we mentioned earlier, but these are geysers. This is where water shoots up from the ground. It's really hot. You might have seen them in New Zealand, for instance, which incidentally is 57% powered by renewable sources, such as geothermal. So they're up there as well. Now what happens with a geyser is the land water seeps down through the earth and hits the hot magma, which then explodes up to the surface and superheated, like you're super cooking something. And that's where you get these amazing pressures. Now, we sat here for ages waiting for it to go off and try and capture it on film. I got some still photos of it, but didn't get any actual film of it, which is a bit disappointing. Again, here you can see the stark landscape in Iceland. It's absolutely beautiful, and you can imagine in winter that this would all be covered in snow. Mind you, it would probably be really the moment as well. This was about 3 in the afternoon, so the sun might have gone down in winter. The geysers pop out of nowhere, really. It's amazing. Little hot spots all over the place. Here we have a little bubbling one that's come to the surface. It's nice when you see these things everywhere that it's actually steam, not smoke. And Reykjavik actually gets its name as Smoky Harbour. These little packets of cigarettes with rye in it, does it mean smoke? There's a geyser actually going off. Yeah, and geysers internationally get their name from the name of this geyser, which is called geyser. I can't say it in Icelandic because I don't have the accent. Now you can see here, these are actually the plates moving apart. That there was the American plate. And over the other side of the clearing, you have the Eurasian plate. And as they're moving apart, there's a massive void between them where all the water's going. So that's actually very, very low. This is Reykjavik at midnight. Creepy place. That's midnight. We just enjoyed some ice cream as well. Sun goes down about 2. Gets up about 4. Never goes dark. Then we went looking for these guys, puffins. Now they're native to the North Atlantic. You don't get them in Australia. And these are lots of puffins flying everywhere. It's very hard to see. But there's a little island just off Reykjavik where they all live. Funny little creatures. They move their wings really, really quickly. You can actually eat puffin. You can get it on the menu. It costs an absolute fortune. And unfortunately, I didn't get the chance to have any puffin. Mind you, I won't confess to eating whale, because apparently it's illegal for Australians to eat whale wherever you are in the world. This is what I'm told. I'd like some proof of that. But you can also buy whale in Iceland, because they've stood up for their own rights, not joined some of the EU commissions, and are still hunting whale. I won't report that it tasted okay. Reykjavik on our last day. We were very sad to leave it. It's a beautiful town. It's really clean, crisp. Icelandic people are really nice. They're Nordic, so they're very good looking, I have to say. It really was a beautiful place. We were very sad to see it go. And then flying away. All trips have to come to an end at some stage, and I will definitely go back. Thank you for joining me today. My name's Marc. I don't know. Turn off the light and I'll glow. Extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal, light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance, crush the speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly, when I play a dope melody, anything less than the best is a felony.